Hi everybody, it's Carla. I wanted to come back on with my next page of my happy journal. I'm not sure what the number of it is now. It's up in the 20s, but I'm nearing to the end of my book. Maybe I have six or seven more pages to do. And this is the one I mentioned yesterday in my video that I had worked on, and I let it sit overnight with some heavy books on it so all the glue and everything would adhere really well. And again, I used the glue sticks. This time I did not stick to pages of the notebook together because I was using some thicker paper. So it's just one page with the thicker papers on top. The very center section with the four seasons, and this is what the theme of this one is, that I love the changing seasons, and that's why there's a heart in the middle. But the thicker paper was a cover of an old thrifted cookbook. And so it has the daffodils for the spring, the sunflowers for the summer, the autumn leaves for fall, and the frosted winter scene of the trees to celebrate winter. And then the outer edges were taken from a travel magazine from AAA that showed some really pretty scenery, and I wanted to pull together the blues off of that and the greens. And the center section had the title of the cookbook in it. Well, I cut that out with an X-Acto knife, and then from behind I put the diagonal striped paper, and the one that I put the heart on top of. And then on top of the page itself, I framed that with some of the similar colored papers there. I also used the similar papers to make four corners to kind of pull the colors together that I was looking for. I thought it turned out really, really pretty, and it's a way to use thrifted items again. And like I said, it was an old cookbook. I've also, this year, my son and I have been talking, and he saw a video that said some minimalizing tips, and it was if you had cookbooks you hadn't used in a long time, pull the recipes out that you are going to use and recycle the covers or whatever. And that's what I did with this one. I ended up keeping the recipes I know I will use, and then keeping the covers to use for artwork. And so I think it turned out really, really pretty. So I hope you like this. And yeah, I had a lot of fun making it. And Lord willing, I hope to continue on and finish this. It's my first art journal, and I wanted it to be a happy journal. And I haven't done the opposite page on these pages yet, except for one that was a two-page spread. And I don't know what I'll do on the other pages. I might just clip some sayings. I might write something. I don't know what I'm going to do. But the main thing I wanted to do was to decorate something with images that made me smile, made me happy, made me remember things that were important to me. And I hope I can encourage you to try your own hand at a happy journal. I think it's just a wonderful thing to have and to look back on, and a creative outlet. And especially if you have odds and ends, I love making things like collages and stuff. So I hope you like this one, and I appreciate everyone that takes the time to watch, and we will talk to you all later. Bye.